We have met perhaps a couple of times, but I now realize that we share something in common, which is Munshi Premchand's Namak Ka Daroga, which had the same effect on me as it had on him. He went to public service and I did not, maybe for this, for similar reasons. I take this opportunity and this invitation as an honor, but I am left to deal with him and his book. I can only set them both in the context that I see them in. So let me address first the man, the book, the context, the remedies, and the conclusion. Not for nothing am I an academic. As for the man, as a policy analyst, I'll be clear. People are not able to hear it. As a policy analyst who has never held public office, for me, it is a professional necessity to read autobiographies and biographies of men and the rare women who have been public servants. And I have read many of these from officers of the East India Company, the ICS and the IAS. I have even read the lectures Friedrich Max Müller told them, gave to candidates of the ICS at Oxford in 1883. Max Müller told them that India offered a great opportunity for them to open their minds and to continue constantly to acquire new knowledge that would make them better human beings with stronger minds. He said it was a privilege that they were getting to go out to India and to rule the country. India offered them a whole range of problems and issues for which they need to apply their minds. He emphasized the great amount of good work that they could do for India and its ancient people. He said he would be glad if in the process it inculcated in them, quote, a real interest in our work, and more than that, a love of our work, and more than that, a true joy and a happiness in our work. These are a set of lectures every high school kid and not just every civil servant should read and think about. Men of character are produced outside the state system and largely by the training of their parents, their inherent drama, dharma and ethics, and their belief in what is right and wrong. The state does not produce them. It is a surprise that the state system does not still destroy them, though many sensitive people are left damaged, disillusioned and broken. There is a notion that merit is the key to almost everything. Collateral to that is that merit is determined by written examinations. For how else could one determine merit? Well, it's not how we choose, if we choose these days. This is not how we choose our son-in-laws or, for that matter, our daughter-in-laws. Let me stop here and clarify that when I speak of state officials, I include not only the entire civil service and bureaucracy, but also the judicial service, the police, the military, the educational and scientific establishment, and everyone who receives a salary or compensation for services to the Republic. It seems to me that a person who has no character, no desire to build a good reputation, no courage to face adversity, no altruism, no ethics, no sense of history, no empathy, and no fear of the hereafter, cannot make a good state official, however well he may pass an exam or two. What the state needs in its service are trained minds, not just trained in measuring land or in processing files, or knowledge of the rules of business, conduct or protocol, or examining the legality and constitutionality of proposed policy or action. These are necessary, but are not sufficient. What is needed is an application of mind. That application of mind needs an open, free-thinking, analytical and innovative mind, which is capable of examining an issue not only in its present context, but tries to forecast the intended and unintended consequences of state policy and action. Such a trained mind will also be in a position to exercise discretion, show fairness and equity, to make exceptions which can be argued and defended on file and produce decent workable solutions to unusual problems. This training does not come easily, and I'm afraid the country is just not producing this kind of people anyway near the numbers needed, least of all in the service of the state. So instead of application of mind, we have application of rules. And even that these days is missing.